Hello Virgo, welcome to Truth Well Told Tarot. This is Andrea and I'm here to do your April 2021 tarot reading for the sign of Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. So let's pull your overarching energy or message for the month of April 2021. Okay, what do we have for Virgo, please? Angels, spirits, guides, message for our lovely Virgos. Okay. Page of Swords. Page of Swords, Virgo. Okay. Message for Virgo, please. Angels, spirits, guides. Message for Virgo. Thank you. Message for Virgo. April 2021, please. Thank you. Oh, nice. I've got trust. I mean, you can see it's almost kind of like this divine body or light is watching over these people. So there is an element of trust. Trust you're being watched over. Okay. So I'm going to pull four cards, Virgo. Can roughly work out as one card per week, though divine timing and all that, the messages may well overlap. And we'll clarify, go deeper into the message. And it won't resonate with everybody, so just take what resonates with you. Okay, so what do we have for Virgo, please? Angel, spirits, guides, message for Virgo. April 2021, thank you. What is the message for Virgo? Okay, Seven of Wands. The Magician, very nice energy. The Tower. Queen of Wands. Okay, can we clarify the cards, go deeper into the message for Virgo, please, for April 2021. Message for Virgo, please. Let's clarify these cards for April 2021. Okay. What do we have for Virgo, please? Angels, spirits, guides, message for our lovely Virgos. Thank you. Starting with this Seven of Wands, message for Virgo. Thank you. Okay. Oh, wow. Seven of Wands. I saw this in the shuffle as well. It's obviously a strong energy here, Virgo. Okay, we have the Magician with the Ace of Cups. Very nice. Tower. We have with the Ten of Cups. And the Queen of Wands we have with the King of Cups. Bottom of the deck we have the Two of Pentacles, Virgo. So I'm going to pull one for this Tower. Let's clarify. It's interesting. I'm getting the Two of Pentacles with that Death card. So change, endings, emerging. Can we clarify this Tower, please, angel spirits, guides? Let's get another card for this Tower. Let's get another card for this Tower, please, angels spirits, guides. Clarify this Tower. So I have the Six of Cups there, Virgo. Let's pull one more. We have the Eight of Cups. Interesting energy. So Virgo, there is definitely some kind of news or information coming here. I mean, the Page of Swords can be about learning something, hearing something, some news or information that's coming to light here. And it's generally the pages of messengers, the beginnings of something new, the beginnings of change. I mean, this can also be you making your mind up in a situation. You know, the swords is to do with the mental energy, our perceptions, our thought patterns, our clarity. So it might well be for some of you something's becoming clear here. There may well be some, I'm kind of getting gossip as well, or you might be hearing things from a, some of you might be hearing some, like I said, it feels like some news or information as well, some of you might be hearing. And there's definitely this energy of trust that you're being watched over, trust that things are going to work out, that kind of energy. It feels it's to do with matters of the heart. Because we have two sevens. Now, the seven is a master number, so do look it up. It is very much divine energy. You're being guided, blessed. But it is also a card of challenge in this card. Challenge to overcome, defending what's right, defending what you know to be true. So there's definitely this kind of energy of you have had some challenge. There's definitely an energy of whatever challenge there is. You are getting on top of a situation of that which opposes you. But there's definitely this energy of it's almost kind of like you were defending what was right. You were defending or standing up for what you believed in. You know, it feels that kind of energy, Virgo. So, and it feels it was to do with a relationship here. Because this definitely is spilling over from March to April. So you will get on top of this challenge. You will overcome this challenge. But this is definitely something that you have been. There's a message, persevere, keep going. You are getting on top of this challenge. But I definitely feel it's there's an energy of defense or defending your, it could be what's right, the truth, standing up for yourself, and getting on top of a situation, something that has been challenging to deal with. We have the Magician. Now, the Magician can also be communication. So again, tying in with this Page of Swords, there could be some communication in terms of this Ace of Cups coming into your world. So the Ace of Cups is first and foremost emotional rebirth, finding that happy place within yourself. It can be an emotional new start for yourself. It doesn't necessarily have to be something physical with the Ace of Cups. It can be a card of just finding that happy place once more, emotional rebirth. And the Magician is, this is what you've been manifesting. It feels for some of you, this is what you've been challenged towards as well. So there's definitely an energy here, Virgo, of finding your own happiness, finding your own happy space, emotional rebirth. Now, there could also be a potential to manifest new love. The Ace of Cups can be having feelings for somebody new, or again, we do have somebody from the past here. So for some of you, it definitely feels in this situation. It feels in this situation that there are new feelings to be explored, maybe for somebody new. It feels like there's a person here with the court cards on the table and you're looking at the possibility of manifesting something with them. It definitely feels the Magician is feeling that magic with somebody. It's a pure energy, you know, it's a pure energy. And is a new start energy. So it feels very, very beautiful indeed. And the reason why I'm saying somebody from the past is so predominant here, because I feel for some of you, somebody who may have caused challenge or walked away, it feels like they're coming back, Virgo. Yeah. The Tower is tearing down of the old. And it feels for some of you that you have been getting to a point where you have overcome or been overcoming, persevering, standing in your own power, your own sense of self, to overcome somebody walking away. But the Six of Cups is, they're definitely coming back. And that is the Tower moment. You know, the Tower is the tearing down of the old. And it feels in this energy, there may have been a Tower moment, but it definitely feels, it feels like either you walked away or they walked away from you. I mean, it can be either or in this energy. But the Six of Cups is an energy of revisiting the past, somebody coming back. And it feels in terms of love, romance, relationships. It feels like a long-term relationship as well, because we have the Ten of Cups here. So it definitely feels in this energy they want the happy ever after again. They want the committed relationship. They want the blissful relationship again. And that is the change that they want to bring with that Tower. They may have caused a Tower in the past. That might have been what you've been challenged on. But the Tower is the neutral energy of simply something that brings change. And the Tower comes crumbling down. It wasn't built to stand the test of time. You know, we have a square Tower, a round crown, and there is definitely this energy of square peg, round hole, something doesn't fit anymore, and change is coming. And it feels it's coming in the form of, like I said, somebody might have caused deep change in your circumstances, but it feels like they're going to cause deep change again. Because again, that Ten of Cups energy, I definitely get this energy of somebody is wanting to get back on track and offer love again. It feels this Ace of Cups is they want the rebirth. Because again, this King of Cups, male or female energy is, remember, the King of Cups will hold the cup. So there's definitely this energy of, it feels like somebody is offering love, romance, relationships here. And the Queen of Wands is an energy. I mean, this could be you, Virgo. It could be the other person. I mean, that, like I said, you could be offering love to somebody. They could be offering it to you. But the Queen of Wands, male or female, like I said, it's a general reading, is somebody who understands how to take calculated action. They act on their instincts. They go for what they feel is right. And they do it from a position of confidence and being in their power. So there's definitely an energy of somebody, it feels like you have the upper hand in this situation. It feels like somebody is coming back and they're wanting to get back on track. It definitely feels they want to start up another relationship again. And again, it definitely feels like you have the upper hand here and you're weighing things up. You know, the Two of Pentacles can be, it feels like this is going to knock you. You know, it's Earth energy, the Two of Pentacles. It's always nice energy in some ways because it's Jupiterian energy. So there's the gift, the expansion, the growth, the good fortune, you know, all of that kind of energy wants to come in. Good things want to come in. But it feels like it's going to maybe take you a little bit by surprise. I get this energy of, well, I won't I, you know? And again, that Page of Swords may well be you getting clarity, you know? There's the curiosity with the Page of Swords, but very much getting clarity on a situation, getting perspective, maybe making your mind up. Yeah, so it feels a powerful month for you, Virgo, definitely. I see somebody of consequence coming back into your life. It feels like you had a long-term relationship with them before, and it feels like they want to start seeing things up again. But there's definitely an energy of you have the upper hand here. I feel you in your power. I'm definitely drawn to that Queen of Wands energy in terms of which way you want to go. And this is about taking your time, you know, taking your time and your own space to say, do I, don't I, will I, won't I? You know, it's that kind of energy. Okay, so I'm going to pull a final message for Virgo. Final message for Virgo, please. final message for our lovely Virgos. Thank you. Yeah, oh gosh, what a word. Unity heart, isn't that funny? I mean, the beautiful thing is the Ace of Cups is you are in a good space anyway. You know, it feels within yourself, your emotions, your capability. You're within a good space anyway because it's been a challenge to overcome. It feels maybe somebody walking away, but you have defended and protected what's yours and stood for what's right. So we have Flamingo, Unity Heart, you are being called to work on collective healing. Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it, that that's come out in the reading. And this feeling of a potential union or united heart. It definitely feels like somebody is asking that question to you. But, you know, there is definitely this energy of their back, but you have the upper hand this time. I hope you enjoyed the reading, Virgo. If you did, please do like, share and subscribe. I hope it's a wonderful month for you all, and I will see you next time. Thank you.